Welcome to one of my favorite levels in the game. In fact, this might be my favorite besides City Escape. There are so many different alternate pathways here, and normally I don't care about alternate pathways in Sonic games. Like, I never replay a level just for an alternate pathway. I do it because the level in general is fun. But here, it's so tempting to replay the level because you see a grind rail going in a different direction. You're like, where does that grind rail go? I want to go that way. The bounce attack can be pretty useful if you're impatient and you want to land on a grind rail pretty quickly. A lot of people say that the controls are so tight that if you try to land on a grind rail from really high up, you land on that grind rail. Well, guess what? I try to adjust my position to the right just a tiny bit, and I end up adjusting it too much and falling to my death. I'm pretty sure in SA1 I would have been able to do that. In this game, it feels like you have to be a lot more careful about how you tap the control stick left or right, because otherwise you'll go too far to left or right. Rail switching is never needed to beat this level. You need to switch rails if you want to get extra goodies. Like, see, I just did it there in an attempt to get the ring boxes. But usually switching rails will just lead you to your death, because you switch onto a rail that's going to end, and then you're expected to quickly switch on to the rail you were previously on. And sometimes I feel like trying to switch rails kills me for no reason. It's not nearly as bad as in Sonic Heroes, though. In Sonic Heroes, you switch rails and it flings you to the side. And that can potentially, if you're holding down the acceleration button while you're trying to switch rails in Sonic Heroes, then your momentum will be so much that you'll get flinged to the side way too much and you'll fall to your death. It's a pretty inexcusable glitch. And that combined with how slippery the controls are in midair, so it's hard to switch rails safely. Bullshit! Bullshit! I tried to climb up that ledge, but for some reason he fell anyways. Yeah, I grinded for lives. Well, actually I didn't. You're gonna notice it anyways. I use an infinite lives code. Because I die here, so... it's just like, fuck it, really. You don't know how annoying it is going through a, like, 5-minute level and then losing all your lives and having to do it all over again. But, aside from that, I hate falling into bottomless pits in this level, but other than that, it's pretty fun, pretty enjoyable. I love holding down the acceleration button on the grind rails and just keep on going faster and faster. And losing your balance and falling off them is not as easy as you think it is. Because I remember in the multiplayer Sky Rail mode, where there's an entire level devoted just to grinding, I did nothing but hold down the B button the entire time that I went through that level, and I didn't fall off the grind rails to my death once. I like how there's arrows there pointing exactly where you're supposed to go, so that you aren't blindly stumbling into the camera, but if you want to outrun the camera, you can. Like, you don't have to wait for the camera to completely finish shifting. You can just follow the arrows and know where to jump. I like that, that's good design. I really wish you could homing attack onto those grind rails instead of hoping you air dash into them successfully, though. And of course you need enough momentum in order to get up these things. Not many Sonic games have you grinding up rails. I mean, there's Sonic 06 where you're grinding forwards with the rail and it gradually starts going up. But at least here, you're grinding upwards, but it sort of makes sense because you have to have enough momentum going towards it in order to grind up it. And after this game, his grinding doesn't really make much sense because he's grinding because he has shoes, soap shoes, that are specifically designed to make grinding easier. In later games, he does rail grinding with his regular sneakers, which is kind of weird. But he's a magical hedgehog who can run at the speed of sound, so I can accept him having magical powers like that. It really sucks dying because you were sent forwards really quickly, and then you overshot, like, you were running too fast, and then you didn't jump in time. There's a point in the level where you hit a spring and it sends you towards a rail that sends you really high upwards. What you need to do is hold down B the entire time, because if you're not accelerating, then you won't be able to reach the next spring and progress to the level. But aside from, it is pretty annoying falling to your death here, but I really do love this level. I love how grinding is handled in this game. You go so fast, and it's not mindlessly automated, and you don't need to do nerve-wracking rail switching. Because I'll admit, rail switching can be kind of nerve-wracking in this game. Mainly because I never do it. So, I'm not used to it, and so I can't really do it quickly, going from one grind rail to back to the previous one, because switching to a grind rail is usually a bad idea, because that grind rail is going to end. You always want to take the center one when you get to a room like this. The left-right ones give you alternate pathways, but most of the time they just give you goodies and springs to send you right back to where you were. That's no gun truck. It doesn't even play a special theme when you're being chased by those things, whatever they are. I like the level. Barely made it. It's pretty fun. Like, I love how there's so many different alternate pathways and you move really fast through it. I love how rail grinding is handled. Not as good as Cityscape, though. I love the scene. The atmosphere and the fact that it's silent until...
You surprised me, Blue Hedgehog. I thought that capsule you were in exploded in space.
You know, what can I say? I die hard. You actually saved me, you know.
It was a Chaos Emerald, wasn't it? But there's no way you could have activated the Chaos Control using an emerald that's fake.
It has the same wavelength and properties. Remember that.
What are you anyway?
What you see is what you get. Just a guy that loves adventure. I'm Sonic the Hedgehog.
I like how he was humble there instead of actually telling him that he's the hero of the world. No, it's something that he should be telling him. And you can't really hear what they're saying all that well because the music is drowning out everything that they're saying. But that's what subtitles are for. It doesn't really bother me all that much. What does bother me about the scene is that they're continuing to talk to each other while they suddenly start running. I think what you need to do here is, for the first part of the fight, spin dash into him. But you can't let him get too far ahead of you, or he'll start spamming projectile attacks at you. If he moves too far ahead of you, then eventually it'll get to the point where the racetrack thing that you're on will crumble. And so it's kind of hard to... Like that will happen. Thankfully, there's always arrows pointing you in the correct direction to go. So I immediately knew that I was suddenly headed the wrong way there. At first, spin dashing into him works, but eventually he'll get wise to and start jumping. And so, your best bet is to light speed dash into him. But the problem is that, due to the way the rings are placed, it's not always guaranteed that he's going to teleport and there's going to be a trail of rings there. So, it's kind of a crapshoot. I mean, I love how fast it is constantly using the light speed dash on the rings and moving really fast. I really miss the days when you actually went fast with the lightspeed dash, and could use them on any rings for that matter, because in later games you're restricted to only certain trails of rings that are glowing gold. Making it mandatory to do lightspeed dash is kind of an automated quick time event, only without random button presses, because you just press B and then you go along them to progress. At least here, you can use it for speedrunning, because you constantly use the lightspeed dash and you move really quickly.
Sonic, I did it!
I like how sad the scene is. Like, it feels like a hollow victory for them. But then they find out Sonic is alive.
Awesome job, Tails!
Notice how Eggman grabbed the real emerald. And, like Tails said, the fake emerald has the same wavelength and properties, but is less powerful than the real one. Which means that it is still powerful. Tails did basically make a Chaos Emerald, it's just not as powerful as the real one. That's why it makes sense that Sonic was able to use Chaos Control with it. That and he has so much experience with using Chaos Emeralds that he has a lot of Chaos Energy inside of him already, so he just drew from that and it added to his fake emerald and made him capable of something that normal people would not be able to use a fake emerald for. So that's why it kind of makes sense to me. That and he saw Shadow use it, so I guess he was able to figure it out. And Shadow does possess generally the same abilities that Sonic does. Like he can spin dash, move the speed of sound, homing attack, somersault. He can basically do everything Sonic can do, so it makes sense that Sonic would figure, maybe I can use Chaos Control too. But anyways, that was the hero story of Sonic Adventure 2. The hero story generally has the much better gameplay. That's not to say the gameplay of Dark Story sucks, but there's barely any Shadow levels for the Dark Story. And the Shadow and Sonic levels are obviously the best levels in the game, so that's kind of a disappointment. The main appeal of the Dark Story is the story. And I'll go into detail about why I think the story is the best later on. Because right now, it's pretty simple. Like, the hero story was pretty simple. It was just, Eggman's bad, go stop him. I mean, at first, it was kind of tense and made you feel sorry for Sonic because he was framed, and so the government was chasing after him. And so he's pretty serious about stopping Shadow and Eggman because he wants his reputation back. But for the most part, the story is just, Eggman's bad, go stop him. Go into space and stop him from trying to take over the world. Pretty simple. Pretty normal. There is the added thing of Amy wants to help out, but she doesn't have enough cool abilities to help out. So she's just a tag along, really. And naturally she gets kidnapped because why didn't she use her hammer? Well, I guess Eggman was a lot taller than her on the mech, and he pointed a gun at her, so she figured that she couldn't try anything. Well, it didn't really look like a gun, so I can understand why people didn't complain too much. And again, it was pretty nice that Sonic was not a dick to Knuckles like he usually is, and vice versa. Like, Sonic actually was helped up by Knuckles. And he let him balance on him while he was woozy from the Chaos Control. The theme that plays here is It Doesn't Matter. There's two versions of Sonic's theme for the Adventure games. And I'm conflicted on which one is better because SA1, it sort of takes too long enunciating the syllables. And so it kind of feels cheesy in that respect. But SA2's Sonic theme feels kind of lackluster. Like, it sings too quickly.
Eggman steals the research from a military base located on an island to the south. The military's top secret weapon, Shadow. Sealed in the space colony park, the 7 Chaos Emeralds. When all of the keys have been collected, world conquest will be at hand. Sonic Adventure 2, The Dark Side Story, Long Live the Eggman Empire.
I love that. I love how they have an entire trailer dedicated to hyping you up for playing the next story in the game. That's awesome. It's really well done. There's so many different cuts between different important scenes, and it perfectly illustrates what the story's about. I'll see you from the next part, where we're going to be starting the Dark Story.